Hello everyone, this is Carlos and today I'm going to be talking about why the RP3 is so unique. I'm going to list you 5 reasons why the RP3 is so unique and special. Some of the fastest and more technical rowers in the world are using the RP3 on their training. To list a few of them, we have Mahe Drysdale, Olympic champion on the single. We have quoted him saying, "I feel rowing on the RP3 the same things I feel rowing on my single is the closest thing I feel to rowing my single, rowing the RP3. We have also Kim Crow from Australia, single scholars, world champion 2013. We have Emma Twigg, who won recently in 2014 the world championships in Amsterdam, training on the RP3 as well. And we have lately got the Croatian double, very powerful and technical crew. I remember they're scholars that row the double scull. They row each one with one oar, which is a very technical boat, and they have a very powerful stroke, and they love the RP3. The second reason why the RP3 is so unique and special, it is the flywheel. It's over 10 pounds. They are all made by hand, riveted. Here you have the asp, and it's a very heavy, and it has a special moment of inertia, which makes the RP3 feels a lot like a boat. So what is important? What is important to have a flywheel that is going to make us feel that rowing motion so similar to the boat? The fact is, as we are rowing and we're getting into the catch on the boat and we put the blade into the water, that feel of connection to the water, that feel of placement and solid grip to the water, it needs to be really similar to here. So as we're moving free into the bottom, we get into the catch and we locked on, that when we engage the flywheel and we engage all our muscles in our body are going to be a key factor of that rowing feel. And that's very determined by how the flywheel is built and how the air works into the flywheel and the moment of inertia of the flywheel. Other thing is, as soon as we locked on the blades and we're going to send the boat away, the way we're going to suspend our weight, we're going to lose weight into the seat, and we're going to push into the feet and have the handle coming and then produce the acceleration that will send the boat away, that is very difficult to simulate. Because what we're talking is, we need to simulate that we are sending the boat away. So the mass, the feel, the acceleration of the movement, the way the handle is coming, the feet are going, and our body is still lifted and suspended from the sea, that has all to do with the flywheel and how the flywheel affects all that motion. The third reason is the power of the direct feedback. Every stroke real time, we get the power curve, the mountain. We can see what's happening during the power application on the curve. And also we can click any of the cells and we can change any of the stroke length, power application, and like the peak force position, ratio, drive time, recovery time, all that through that direct feedback that we get on real time as we're rowing the machine. Four reasons why the RP3 is so unique: you can link them together to get crews developing the right coordination and synchronizing each other. So you can use those connecting bars. This one will connect two machines next to each other. And as we mentioned in other video, you can connect 2, 4, 6, 8 machine. You can have a big beam in the middle who connects them all. So you can be training, coaching your 8 on land and all moving together like they'll do on the water. That makes RP3 really unique. The last reason why RP3 is so unique, I feel RP3 has at this moment, after 6 years of being in the strongest program in the country, in the USA, rowed by the stronger male athletes with Olympic medals. I mean, you can get the amount of power and effort that those machines get hold. The machine has evolved to a moment now that I believe can handle any athlete with any kind of pressure. It is a key machine because the amount of pressure that you can deliver on the feet as it's moving into a bar and is simulating that dynamic freedom and that floating motion is a very complex engineering, and the adjustments are tricky with that amount of pressure. And the speed of the flywheel, we were talking before, the flywheel is a key factor. The acceleration and the speed that flywheel gets and nothing vibrates is difficult. And we have got to a moment we're very happy with it. This is Ben Carlos. Thank you for watching.